For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life.
You see, this is our tune today. And I can tell you exactly what the story is in a moment, but I wanted you to hear the first two lines. Because it's very easy when you do our tune to say, maybe this person is being a bit self-indulgent. But this one, and the our tune is Celine Dion, it's for two people who couldn't live together, who couldn't carry on together, even though they love each other. So, let's go back to 1999. I won't tell you the name of this person yet, but I will a little later on. He met this stunning young woman. They started to date. Everything was good. They got engaged soon after they met, both known as people who were perfectly compatible. They had to be together. So they got married. They lived happily for 10 years. They had two fabulous kids together, and it was shortly after the birth of their second child that the secret that he had been keeping to himself became something that he really couldn't bear, and he had to tell his wife. The secret was that for many years, since he was about 6 years old, he'd been dressing in female clothes. It was a guilt thing, of course, and it was also something he didn't feel he could share with his wife, Janie. So he sat down and felt he had to be honest, and he wrote a letter saying how he felt about this, explaining to her, and that he had no idea why he did, but he just had to dress in women's clothes every now and then. The first thing she asked was he gay? And he said, no, it's nothing to do with it. And then she asked him the really pivotal question, did he want to do this and change into a woman? And he said, no, absolutely not. So you can imagine what the situation was. It was made more and more complicated by the fact that he was very insecure about himself and was still the man of the house. She was very tolerant with him and very able to deal with the situation and tried to understand as much as she could, even to the extent of going out to local shops with him and choosing clothes with him. And then he began to go to local transgender support groups meetings, and he found more people like himself and started to notice that this was taking over. He began to lose weight, found himself taking more care in his looks, and all this time, Janie stood by him and watched her husband change, even though she couldn't see it herself as a something that she could understand. One day, and it was the final straw, he came home with both his ears pierced, and Janie said, can you take the earrings out? And he did, and tried to struggle with himself and tried to cope with it, and a year or so went past, and all he wanted to do was dress more and more as a female. He lost touch with old friends, went out with new girlfriends, people like himself, but he was hurting the one person who meant so much to him. There was no way he could continue, so he sat down with his wife, with Janie, and they talked it out, and she was honest with him and said that she hated the person he was becoming. There was a female taking over her husband. It was Jekyll and Hyde-like, and she really couldn't stand it in any way. And he explained he couldn't stop. He needed to look deep down inside himself, be true to Janie, but also to himself. And he then said, look, this is a road I've got to go down. Will you come down that road with me? But she said no. She married a man, not a woman, and she wanted the man back, and he couldn't give her that, as much as it hurt him, and as much as he knew it hurt her. So he went to see the doctor, was referred to the local psychiatrist, who agreed that he was transgendered and needed to address the matter. And the two of them, Janie and him, sat down together and talked for hours about what they should do. The first thing they agreed that should happen was that he moved out of the family home because he wanted to change his gender, change his sex. That was hard. They'd spent 15 years together, and for him to leave the woman he loved, the woman who was his world, was almost too much. He also felt really guilty because he was ripping the family apart. Knew it was selfish, But more and more, it was the female in him that he wanted to follow. Well, that's all 5 years ago. It's 5 years since he moved out. He's completed the transition. He is now female. He is very happy in himself, but he misses his soulmate. And, of course, he's aware of the damage he's caused. Janie is and was his world, and it's a fair question. Why would he destroy that world at the time when he was having such perfection in family terms? Well, that's a question you'd have to ask him. I don't know. He feels he's very lucky that his family has stuck by me and accepted him for what he has become. He sees his children every 2 weeks. They're okay. Janie has moved on with her life. She's in a relationship with a nice man who takes as much care of her as he used to do. She still single and feels he always will be. He can't ever see himself loving someone like he did with Janie. And the real problem is there's a hollowness there. He's not whole. There's an emptiness. And he's come to terms with the fact that that is it. And that is all it's ever going to be. Janie and he are going through the divorce at the moment. He's still a big part of his family's life, and he hopes he always will be. He knows he's been lucky that he did have love and should be happy with that. And he really feels now that he is himself, herself, but that the future that he'd planned all his life is beyond him.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you... Because you loved me.
What's really sad about this, and it's so easy to be judgmental and think this is the sort of story that you see in a tabloid and you really don't like, but what really is sad about this is the last paragraph from this man, now lady, whose name I'm going to keep to myself. He says, she says, I know I'm very lucky. I did have love and should be happy with that. The song that I feel was mine and my wife's is Celine Dion's Because You Loved Me. The problem is there's an emptiness in her heart. You can see this. I just miss my friend, she said, and my soulmate. But I still wish her all the happiness in the world and always will be there if she needs me. As I said, I can't tell you the person's name because there are two children involved. But it's our tune for this Thursday morning.
Simon Bates. Smooth Radio Breakfast.
With redspottedhanky.com. Book train tickets in advance and save 51% on average. Conditions apply.